back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a little different, and I figured I've been having some things on my mind lately and I just really want to share it. So go ahead and grab your coffee or tea or whatever you choose and just hang out and listen, and hopefully you can get some insight as this has given me insight as well. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up if you do, and let's just get right into it. So I have my phone here because I thought of five things that I tell myself or that I have heard, and I want to stop. I want to stop telling myself these things, and hopefully I can, and it will just encourage me to keep growing. Okay, so the first one is I will always be in debt. So I used to always say this, and I know I've heard it tons and tons of times before, but this is not true. You do not always have to be in debt. And a lot of people are okay with this idea because of cars and phones and all of these things that we physically can't always afford, so we have to finance them. And we're always just okay with being in debt. But there came a point in our lives that I was not okay with owing someone something. I wanted to be done with that and just not owe anybody anything. So the idea of that you will always be in debt doesn't have to be true. I mean, if you can imagine your life without owing anybody anything, imagine what you can do with just a few extra $100s or thousands of dollars, depending on how much you are in debt. Imagine the lifestyle you can have without being in debt. If you are interested in knowing how I have started our debt-free journey, or are interested in just to try to see what you guys can do, if you are interested, just message me on Instagram. I will leave it linked below, and also I will put it on the screen here. So the second thing is that I'm nothing special. So a little backstory to me is I have no college degree. I barely graduated high school, and I really only cared about school when it was my senior year of high school. I always just had this idea of, as I'm nothing special. I'm not really exceptional at things. I don't really have this great gift at something. I feel like, you know, sometimes I don't have a niche in things, but when it comes down to it, you are special, and you are born with gifts and talents that maybe you don't know yet, but you will never know unless you try. So I need to stop telling myself that I'm nothing special, because I know that I am, and that I have the potential to be an exceptional human being. I just have to let myself do that. The third thing that I tell myself a lot is maybe next time. A lot of us, especially I feel like this is when it comes to like New Year's resolutions, like, you know, we'll just wait until the New Year's, that way I can kind of start fresh, new year, new me kind of thing. And especially with like weight loss and just healthiness and personal goals that you set, it's always, oh, maybe next time, or maybe in the future I will start doing this. But honestly, the time is now. You never know when today is going to be your last day, and until you try, you will never know. I mean, it could be so worth it, just taking the chance and facing that fear of doing something that you really want to do despite of what you have or what you don't have. Or I think that kind of bounces off the I'm nothing special kind of thing, is you are, and just do it now and do it with what you have. Don't spend a crazy amount of money or invest in yourself like so much if you don't have the resources. Just use what you have and take full advantage of it. Another one, that this is probably one of my favorites, is that God only gives you what you can handle. Now, this seems like a good thing, but it's not true. God gives you more than you can handle, and there's a reason for this. Just like your parents, they want to see you be bold and brave and come out of your comfort zone to be more than what you think you are. So God has the same mentality. He wants us to be stronger and a more confident person, and he wants us to just get out of our comfort zones and be bold. And so he's going to give us trials and tribulations that will literally bring us out and make us stronger, and it will be so worth it. So yes, God gives you more than what you can handle, but it will all work out in His time, and it will be so worth it. I promise you that. There have been so many times where I questioned, you know, all the trials that I've been in, or wondered if I'm ever going to see the light at the end of the tunnel. But the second I do, I know that all those trials before were so worth it, because at the end of the day, I came out of them a stronger and more confident person. So last but not least is, I don't know how. A lot of people say, and I know I've said this, is I don't know how. But really, that is a big excuse, and I mean that sincerely. So a lot of us don't know how, and that's okay. A lot of times I didn't know how, especially when I was starting my YouTube channel. There are things that I did not know. So I researched a ton of stuff, and not only can you figure out things on YouTube, but Google, I mean, you can literally type in something on YouTube or Google and figure it out. And if you can't figure out the first time, there are so many other like blogs and videos and any, like all these other tutorials on things. You can always learn how. So don't feel afraid if you don't know how, because you are always capable of learning something new. And yes, it might take a little extra time, it might take some practice, but practice makes progress. So if you don't try, then you can't practice. And if you don't practice, you won't make progress. So just stay patient with yourself, give yourself grace. You know, we are all in different seasons of life. You just need to have that vision of really what you want and go for it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a good day wherever you are. Please make sure to subscribe if you want to be part of our family, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.